Only one person in the history of Canada has won 7 medals at an Olympics total. She is joining us now, the one, the only, Penny Oleksiak from Toronto.
Yes.
Congratulations, Penny. Let me get up.
Yes.
What am I doing? I gotta get up.
We are so thrilled to have you on the show. A massive congratulations from us here, from the nation, from the world. We are so proud of you. I know you haven't heard it. You've heard it over and over and over, but we can't say it enough. The most decorated Canadian athlete. Is that still sinking in for you?
It's weird. I definitely have had like a couple times where I'm hanging out with a friend and I'm like, is it not weird that I'm like the most decorated Canadian athlete? Like, that's weird to me. You know what I mean?
I don't know what you mean because I'm not athletic in any way, shape, or form, but only you really know what that means, Penny, with all due respect. Now, people who might not know, and just so people at home know, she's not in Tokyo because COVID regulations where your events are done, you got to get the heck out of Dodge, and you are home, which also means you do not get to carry a flag into any closing ceremony. You know, there are a lot of worthy Olympians that could carry that flag, but the fact that you can't even be in the conversation, is that the only disappointment, really, of the last couple of weeks?
I think, honestly, I kind of had such a good experience there, and I think for me, I go to race, and that's what I'm there to do, and I honestly didn't even know that we still had a closing ceremony. So, I mean, when people started talking about me carrying the flag, I was just, I don't know. I was already came to terms with the fact that I had to go home. So, I mean, as nice as it would be, I think at the same time, I'm trying to just really live in the good moments of the Olympics.
Oh, there are so many good moments. There are great moments. There are phenomenal record-breaking moments. Let's talk about your teammates. We're seeing some pictures here. 4 of them joined us on the show just the other day. There is such pride and camaraderie between all of you and Team Canada. What's it been like? Again, like I said, it was alluding to a very different Olympics. You can't always be with one another, but what was it like to have your core group?
It was definitely really nice. You know, I think I look at a lot of those girls like family, and just getting to race with girls that I have grown up with since I was like 9 is amazing. And I really appreciate having those girls with me and behind the blocks and in the ready room, and just, it's always a good time with them.
Penny, you are really good on social. And I want to bring up the tweet. I know you've heard it a million times. Forgive me, Penny. this is the tweet you sent out a few days ago. I'm going to read it verbatim. And Mel read it earlier this week. It's worth repeating now that you're here. I just Googled Canada's most decorated Olympian, and my name came up. I want to thank that teacher in high school who told me to stop swimming to focus on school because swimming wouldn't get me anywhere. This is what dreams are made of. End of awesome Penny tweet. Penny, I'm not going to ask you for a name because I know you're not going to give it to me.
No.
But have you been in any type of contact with said teacher since you posted that?
No, I haven't. I think, I don't even know if the teacher knows who it is. So, I mean, it was less directed at the teacher, more directed at the haters and people who tell people that they shouldn't pursue their dreams and their passions.
Love that. You had a follow-up tweet, though, which was, listen, respect to all teachers. I was just talking about that one. And then you wrote hashtag WOAT. I had to Google that. Do you know what that means, Sid? WOAT?
Was it worst of all time?
Yes.
Is that it?
Yes. Thank you, Sid. Yeah. I did not know that, Penny. I want to also say you have the most gracious family. You have an incredible family, a very athletic family, if you don't know the Oleksiak family. Your parents were on, let's say, I guess it was a week ago, and they said there's a ritual that they have when they watch you race. They sit on the couch in the same sequence, right? Same order. And if they don't what's that?
I'm not surprised.
You're not surprised. Do you have a ritual before you race?
Honestly, I want to say no, but definitely I am really like, I have to follow the exact like order of things that I do or else I start stressing it. Like I have to warm up in a certain order. I have to like get in the water at a certain time, have my coffee at a certain time before I race. I have to listen to a specific song before I race. But then I would tell you I'm not super superstitious.
Yeah. We need to know what song, Penny. What song are you listening to?
Oh, a really like hectic EDM song that I'm not.
That's any EDM song.
I know, but I listen to like anything that's just like someone screaming at me aggressively.
Oh. Whatever motivates you, Penny.
Whatever works.
Seems to be working.
Yeah.
Penny, again, I want to emphasize again to our guests as we say goodbye here. 21 years old, more medals than anyone else in the history of Canadian Olympic competition. You are, I mean, Paris ain't that far away. L.A. really, you know, it's kind of far away, but it's still relatively close. You are an inspiration, Penny, to so many people, never mind young athletes in this country, to people. And I just want to congratulate you and, quite frankly, thank you for the way you have represented this country competitively in and out of the pool. And I know you're just getting started. So all the best to you and the family. Thank you for joining us today. Congratulations again. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much.
Penny Oleksiak.
Penny Oleksiak.
Woo! Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow. Doesn't get better than that.
Devo with like the last lap bow, really. Very Olympics of
right?
you, Devo.
I got you.
Very good. Very good.
I love her. And she's so humble too, you know? Just, if you were the most decorated Olympian ever, Sid, would you be
if
like?
If I had a bronze in, like, archery, I'd be, like, I'd be obnoxious as hell.
Booyah, booyah. Yeah. You'd be doing dances.
I'd be like, look at this guy. Wow. Penny carries herself with a great amount of class and dignity. And, again, she's just getting started here. That was a great opportunity. And hopefully you enjoyed that at home as much as we did here. Natasha Ramsahai joining us with some weather. Natasha, she's great, ain't Tosh?
Yeah, no, she's great. Absolutely great. Like, she's so young, right? And it's that Mamba mentality that Kobe used to talk about, right? She's got that mindset, and it's just go, go, go. That's how she comes across to me. So, and celebrated from coast to coast. So.